As I said earlier, you will see that I know you are pretty busy, okay, working on various kind of things. Just for you to know, we have the possibility to actually track what you are looking at. So we know if you have looked at that before coming. So what I suggest, depending how you feel, we completely agree that maybe you will not have time to do everything, but at least try to either look at the PowerPoint or look at the video, or depending on what you prefer. But don't come just like out of the blue, sitting, waiting for the tutor to go through the PowerPoint or whatever, because it's not going to happen. We don't have the time. Okay? So it's really collecting, just like, you know, cruising through, that will enable you to actually identify where are the things you don't understand. So you can just like go straight to, you know, the question you don't understand. If there is something you don't understand, there is a 100% chance that another student is not understanding it. Okay? So don't be shy. That's really a safe place. That's where you are, you know, here to learn and to progress. So feel free to ask questions, that's the best way to do it. Okay? For the returning students, what would you say was the most difficult in the previous units you had to study? Just for them to know.
That is okay, that's right, but what
What else? What does it mean? What is going on? And that's something that is going to go throughout all your units. That's really, at the master level, that's really something you need. I would say that's the main difference when I'm teaching undergrad and graduate. If you're looking at a strategic unit at undergrad level, they will do a 5-4-6. They will do a PESTEL. That's exactly. Now, at the graduate level, it's once you need to know how to do that, you need to know what is the logic behind why are we doing that. You need to know what is the implication of your analysis, and so on. So, the doing the tools is the best, is the first part, but then at the master level there is this other step that is actually saying, giving you an example, PESTEL, so political, economic, legal, blah blah blah. Any idea when it was created? In terms of time? Don't Google it, just try, give it a shot. When do you think it was created? In terms of time, a date.
Because that's giving you
try to find where the word is coming from, because that gives you some elements of understanding. Giving you another example in English, labor, labor. So that's the British, or if you prefer the English. So it means working and all these kind of things. Okay. Is there another meaning?
Deliver.
Okay. And most of the time, when you are in labor as a woman, it's not really funny, is it?
Yes.
So you have already in the world a notion of power that is going to take place, a notion of suffering, if you want. So from an academic point of view, and if you have more of a Marxist approach, you can say that within the world, you already have this war of classes, you know, the rich against the poor, and all those kind of things. We have exactly the same thing in French, where the word is actually translated in what we call travail. Okay? And the word is coming from trepalium, and trepalium in Latin was a tool that was used to torture people. So that's kind of, you see, you have being able to understand where the word is coming from is actually giving you insight about all the different concepts, where it's coming from, and how you can understand them. Okay? So that's something I would recommend you when you are actually working with concepts and stuff like that, to try what do they really mean, when were they created, because that has an impact. That's another thing that students are asking me when it comes to references. How old can we go when we have references? How long ago do they have to be current, and all those kind of things? Once again, the main issue here is some of the things we are talking about were discussed a long time ago, and the people that created them are dead and all those kind of things, but they were the ones that created them. And you need to be able to prove that you know both who created them and how it has evolved. So for me, it's perfectly natural to have a mix of dates within your reference, because if you are talking at experiential marketing, experiential marketing was developed by someone that is called Maurice Holbrook, that was a professor at Concordia, I think, university, in the 60s. So the first thing you do is you state that the term was coined or designed by Maurice Holbrook, so your reference is quite old, and then you put some new elements, the latest development in the field of experiential marketing, to prove that you have the knowledge of both. Okay? Anything else I can do to help you, or if you have any questions, comments? No?
Yeah, but
you are only using old books.
Yes.
That's why you need a mix of those different elements. Okay? I've done my PhD on Sun Tzu and Clausewitz in strategy. Sun Tzu and Clausewitz, well, they are dead a long time ago. But what I've done is use that concept and mix them with more recent elements. So it's making sure you have a mix of those different elements. I mean, you don't have the choice. At one point in what you are going to do, you are going to reference the Ansoff Matrix. Okay, you will see that framework. The Ansoff Matrix was created in the 60s by Ansoff. There is no, how can I say that? If you talk about Ansoff Matrix, of course you reference Ansoff. That's something that we are still using. Okay? So you reference Ansoff, but you also reference what are the more recent applications. And you don't stick to just Ansoff, you add some new elements. So there is a mix of all. Yeah. I know that now you have access to Emerald journals.
Yes.
So what I would do is when you reference, one way of doing it is actually trying to know where you need to look for information. In UK there is what we call the Chartered Association of Business School, and they are publishing a ranking. Okay? And the ranking is actually ranking what they think are the best journals in the world. Okay? And there are actually there is a typology, so you have some in human resource, you have some in strategy, you have some in really different elements. Okay? Once you look at them, that's giving you hints where you can actually look at. I'm just going to show you that. You just do ABS ranking. I'll just take this one. There is one about 2018, but it's more complicated to get it. So Yeah, just, I will come back to you just to finish here. So what they are doing is seeing in the tables, they, what they are doing is they provide area by field in management, a list of journals that they consider the best one. ABS ranking. And they rank them level 1 to 4. 4 are the best. 3 and 4 are the best. Okay? Some of those journals are part of EnRand. Some of these journals are published by EnRand. Okay? So you already know that if you are going in those journals, your references are going to be really, really good. Okay? So if you go back to answer your question, if you go back to your assignments, the first assignment is actually to ask you to produce a focus strategy analysis of the external environment. So you look at what is happening in the environment and then demonstrate the implication of this analysis for the strategic marketing position of the organization. So it means that you need to know what is the strategic marketing position of your organization. That's where you're going to include your internal elements. So the internal elements is really, I'm looking at the marketing position of my firm, I'm looking at what is going on in the environment, and then I'm doing an analysis in terms of how what is going on in the environment going to impact my current strategic marketing, my current marketing position. Make sense? Then, the second one is more about providing and evaluating strategy and marketing options. So, once you know what is going on in the environment and how that can impact your firm, then you can take different decisions. That's your different options. Okay. And you're going to evaluate those options to actually come up with a recommendation the firm should do this when it comes to strategy and marketing. Recommendation. they would just like jump on the recommendation without doing any analysis. So here, we have actually divided that to make sure the first assignment is the analysis, and then you take your decision, your recommendation, based on the analysis. Can be any organization, as long as you will have enough information to identify their marketing strategy. Because if you go there, if you take your first assignment, the first assignment is actually stating, demonstrate the application of this analysis for the strategic marketing position of the firm. If you are not able to collect information about the strategic position of the firm, you're not going to be able to do that. Okay? So you can take any organization as long as you will have enough information to identify what is the marketing position of the firm. Yeah, because the main issue you got is that we do not accept primary data. So it has to be backed up by published. So but when we say published, there is two different things. What we are going to ask you to do in your references is have two different types of data or of reference, if you want. You will have the academic one that are actually coming from what we said earlier, that is your ABC ranking and just like more, you know, the theory and all these kind of things. But you will also need what we call empirical data that you will find on the website of the firm that you may, I don't know, do they have access to a market line or not? No, but you have some databases where you can find some reports. The Financial Times, that might be Myanmar journals, okay, that are talking about, you know, a firm. Would be better if it's in English, because we can check it, but at the same time, you know, if it's in Myanmar, I mean, if it's relevant for you, it's always, that's what I said earlier, what is better? You working on a firm about Myanmar, having reference from Myanmar, or you working on the NHS with UK reference about the NHS? I prefer the first solution because I think that's where there is the most added value. Okay? But we will need some reference. And if there is, I would say, if I want to be really picky and say, okay, those references are, you know, in Burmese and I don't understand a single word and I don't know if they are good or not, that's why they are there. So we can actually send them an email and say, wait a sec, you know, they have referenced this journal or this newspaper. What is it? Is it the equivalent of the Sun of the Daily Mail or is it the Guardian? Okay? If it's the Sun or the Daily Mail, not going to work because that's trash paper. If it's, you know, the Guardian or the Financial Times or whatever, that's paper that have a bias, yes, but they also have status. Okay? As long as you can provide evidence of what you're saying, that's fine. Choice of the organization, different ways of doing it, actually. There is what I would say, a bottom-up approach or a top-down approach. So the bottom-up approach is, and there is a third one, but that is completely different. So the first one, the bottom-up is, you have always an interest in one specific organization and you want to know more about this one. So that you're going from the organization and then you move back up to the industry. The The other one is actually identify the industry you are interested in and then go deeper to actually try to select an organization. The third one is once again discussing with your tutor and saying, do you have any idea? Do you think I can do this? And you know, it's really, really funny because we never win. Which means that when you are saying to your students, you have to work all those organizations, you always have a student that is coming and saying, I cannot choose my organization, I want to choose it. Okay? And when you are saying, well, you're free, you do whatever you want, you're always like, no, 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 no. So it's always in between. So that, but you know, you have backup. If you're really, really completely lost, don't hesitate to talk with your tutor. There are, as I said, another way of looking at it is looking what is current, what are actually the firm we are talking about, currently what are the ones that are making the news, and why, all those kind of things. Because that's where, as I said earlier, you have some firms that we have talked about over and over and over again, and it's not really, really interesting. Doing an analysis of Apple, it's not interesting anymore. It's been done, and even if you are doing that really, really well, that's not where the notion of creativity or reflexivity is going to show up. Whereas if you are talking of a firm like Tesla, where Tesla is really, really interesting, because if you look at it, they have, well, before all the problems currently, they had a really, really good reputation. Everyone was saying Tesla, just like innovative firms that are coming with such good ideas and blah, blah, blah. But at the same time, they were in a financial mess. So you have this dichotomy here between a firm that has a wonderful image, everyone is just like praising it, but that has pretty, pretty big problem. And from a strategic and marketing point of view, that's a challenge. And that's something that is really interesting to actually look at. So the fact you are choosing a firm like that is actually already providing added value compared to someone that is going to go for McDonald's or whatever. And that can, you know, that can be something you want to discuss with your tutor. There is, if you're looking at what is planned, there is some time to actually discuss about the firm and the choice of the firm and the choice of the industry, which one you want to be. The main thing is try to think about it before starting, so you can actually adjust. What is going to happen is you are going to come up with an idea, but you will need to actually need a little bit of time to start collecting the information, and maybe you will see, no, I can't have enough information, so I have to change. Or maybe you will see you have too much information and you have to actually find a way to break that down, and so on and so forth. So the sooner you have an idea of what you want to do, the better, the best it is, because you can actually test it and see if it's going to be feasible or not. Don't put yourself in a position where you are framed to fail, I would say, which is selecting a firm where you won't be able to find any information, or an industry where it's a mess, that you don't understand at all what is going on, all those kind of things. Try to avoid a monopolistic position, because that's not interesting. But if you have a firm that is in a monopolistic position, they can do whatever they want. So your strategic analysis is not going to be interesting. So all those kind of things have to come in mind. My last, the last book I had in strategy worked on Netflix. And they were just like mad at me because they worked so much on it that they were, we cannot even look at it at night. We don't want to watch it because it reminds us that we have to do an assignment. We used to watch it just like, you know, to relax, it's really nice, we're going to watch a series, and they wouldn't do it anymore because they were thinking about strategy and that would bring them stress. So that was really fun. But that's another one that is really, really interesting too, because it Any firm.
Enough resources.
Yeah.
And should be, you know, just monopoly.
Yeah. So that can be a young offer. If there is enough information, that's fine.
So we get interesting people.
Yeah, a lot of company.
Yeah.
So do you know what they're doing testing, right? If the guy is not doing just shooting,
the
time is not.
The thing, if you want, that there is, the way the assignment is based is you need a certain type of information.
Okay?
If you don't have access to this information, you won't be able to make the assignment. So it's a no-brainer. I mean, if you don't have access to the information, of product compared to your competitor? Where are you in terms of So you are going to explain who designed that, and then the empirical evidence are actually going to be the fact that your firm is a middle range price firm, and you can justify that with evidence when you compare it to your competitors. So I've got some academic evidence when I'm defining the framework, and I've got what I call empirical evidence, that is actually what is going on when I look at my price compared to my competitors. Yes.
So price,
yes.
Okay.
first thing you reference on, and you're referencing to you what you are using and citing in your paper, and you're referring to what you looked at, that you are citing, using. Management practice is based on a simulation where how many students?
Five.
Okay, because usually what we are doing, we are it's better to be a group because you are in competition. So I think what we will have to do is to actually be alone, each student creating its own airline. It's going to be an airline in the street. Weeks 1 to 6. Okay. I'm just trying to, that's not my unit, so I'm just discovering also what she has decided to do. I'm just going to look at all first deadline is the 9th of November. And there is just one, I think. So, I'm just going to go and look at what you will have to decide first is the way it works is you have the software, okay? You have to actually pay something to register. And then once it's done, you have specific time to take some decisions. Okay? And the decisions are going to be based on different things.